Why are protesters putting cones on the hoods of San Francisco's robotaxis?
I think broadly, San Franciscans are just tired of being tech guinea pigs.
These videos are from Safe Street Rebels, a group that's pushing back on the massive expansion of fully autonomous self-driving cabs in the city. According to the group, coning the cars temporarily disables them and, poetically, marks them as the hazard the group argues they are. Nicknamed robotaxis, these driverless rides began hitting San Francisco's roads in February 2022 and have divided folks ever since. The two companies currently using the city as a proving ground for the tech are Cruise, backed by GM, and Waymo, which is owned by Alphabet, Google's parent company. Certainly, what they promise is impressive.
Waymo is taking what was once futuristic sci-fi and making it non-fiction.
These driverless cars promise all the convenience of car travel without the downsides of having a person at the wheel. For instance, Waymo is keen to remind us that human drivers have a tendency to drive even when they're tired or drunk. They can't see in the dark, and they have limited range of vision even in the best conditions. The company's Jaguar I-Pace taxis, meanwhile, are kitted out with LiDAR, cameras, and radar that give it information from all 360 degrees, no matter the light level or weather outside. And passengers of Cruise, which relies on similar sensory tech, were impressed with how smooth the ride turned out to be.
Like, the car drove better than most of the drivers I've been in the back of a car with before, and yet there was nobody there.
There are other perks that come with having a driverless taxi too. Your ride won't bail on you if they see you holding a car seat, need a ride to the airport, or because of prejudice. Conversations around the safety of the vehicles have hinged largely on the likelihood of collisions, and we'll get to that, but there's more to a safe cab ride than crash risk. In 2020, Uber disclosed that over 1,000 cases of sexual assault had been reported by passengers in the US. It's easy to see why a driverless taxi would be an attractive option, particularly after dark in a big city.
Oh my God, this is so cool.
So why is Safe Street Rebels trying to take these cars off the road? Robotaxis like Waymo and Cruise might solve some problems for passengers, but they're causing problems all of their own. Emergency services in particular have found wayward driverless cars to be a nuisance. In this instance from February 2023, a police officer's camera captures them trying to stop a Waymo from inching forward over a fire department hose in use.
No! You stay!
The San Francisco Fire Department has reported 55 instances in the last 6 months where a driverless car got in the way of them doing their jobs. San Francisco Fire Department Chief Janine Nicholson said in a meeting about the issue, "It's not our job to babysit their vehicles." In August, a Cruise car failed to yield to a fire truck en route to an emergency, causing a collision and injuring the passenger. It's not just emergencies either. These cars are stalling out in situations they should be able to handle, like this busy intersection. When the cars finally moved, the nearby crowd cheered. Removing the driver may solve some problems, but for Safe Street Rebels, cars themselves, autonomous or not, need to go in favour of reliable public transit and cycling lanes. Despite protests, California has given Cruise and Waymo the go-ahead to operate the autonomous ride services 24/7. Would you ride in a robotaxi?